Lieutenant Colonel Moses Musinguzi from SFC thanked Ugandans for their support towards the armed forces. He encouraged Ugandans to maintain a good relationship with them for nation building.
Today we are here to recognize and thank Ugandans for the contribution they have made to the well-being of this country. We thank them for the contribution. We thank them for the support they have always given to UPDF. So far we are what we are because of them.
Meanwhile, the Uganda People's Defense Forces, together with its sister forces, the Uganda Police Force, Uganda Prisons and Wildlife Authority, today spend the day doing the final touches ahead of the 42nd Tarehe Sida celebrations. The construction team were also busy fine-tuning the venue, which is expected to host thousands of people. Lieutenant Colonel Deo Akiki, the UPDF deputy spokesperson, said everything will be at 100% completion by the end of the day tomorrow.
Kacheka, the stadium itself where people are going to sit, the pavilion, is being cleaned up by our engineers. And I think by close of tomorrow evening, everything should be set. Because on Sunday, we are going to be handing over the projects that we have done, the civil military cooperation projects related. Renovated hospitals, schools, medical kits that are going to be distributed, and all other activities. As we say now, the preparations are at about 90%. By close of the day, we think we shall be around 95%. By tomorrow, we should be 100% by evening time, so that we are able to welcome His Excellency the President, the CDFs from different countries who are coming to join their colleague CDF General Mbadi here.
This year's Tarehe Sita celebrations will be held in the Greater Mbarara region at Kacheka Stadium as part of the fulfillment of the FRONASA liberation struggle. The region has never hosted the event since 1981. The theme is recognizing the sacrifice of the founder of People's Revolution for socio-economic transformation.
Tarehe Sita is celebrated every year across regions. We choose one region. We were in Elgon last time in the Bugiso area last year. This time when we sat, the Defense Organizing Committee chose that Tarehe Sita be brought to Greater Mbarara. By the way, it has never happened here. This is the first time since 1981. And yet the people of Greater Mbarara played a very, very important role. An example of one of the districts, small district but very instrumental. If you look at Kazo district, Kazo district, as we talk today, offers about 74 senior officers, senior officers and generals. And when you hear of big names like Eli Tumwine, you hear of Chef Ali, you hear of Patricia Lumumba, you hear of Chabihende, all of those generals come from that part of the area.
Colonel Akiki said they will have a beautiful parade from the UPDF and sister forces, adding that they will have indigenous entertainment and awarding of medals to people who participated in the struggle. He said that UPDF is committed to pushing ahead socio-economic transformation and urged all Ugandans to cooperate with the force, as this will help the country grow.
We expect some entertainment from cultural groups, especially those indigenous here. We want a real feel of the cultural performances from this region. We shall have, of course, also awarding of medals of some of the people who participated in the struggle to liberate this country.
Also, residents of Mbarara were fascinated with the parade rehearsal at Kacheka Stadium, with many having piqued interest to send their children to join the army, and hailed UPDF for being a pro-people force.
I was fascinated by the parade, and I'd like to thank him for everything. And a Guzom Naman to call a change in Uganda so that we can develop the infrastructure of the country.
Story compiled by Godfrey Sempija and Abdul Karim Sengendo for the news.